is live telecast on the also live, but today some difficulties in technical fault. We just get connected. I request everyone, please mute your microphone. Okay. Bari sir, can you hear me, sir? Bari sir?
Yes.
Yes, sorry, sir, for today's the technical difficulties. And
no problem.
Okay, sir. Sir, with the permission, with your permission, so, I want to start now.
And,
yes. You know that the Bangladesh Kurgan Fellow Group is organizing this type of interactive learning session from the 7th May of this of the last month. Today we completed almost 14 lecture. Today our 15 and 16 lecture. You know that yesterday Professor Jhunjhunwala, the legendary professor from the India, he joined with us and delivered the deformity talk. It was excellent learning capabilities for us to learn from the masters. So today our two topics, TBL technique, Ilizarovin tibia. It will be presented by Hamidul Islam, working as a assistant professor in NITOR Bangladesh, and another by the Kamruzzaman. He is also the assistant professor working in the Mamashing Medical College. At first, I am inviting Hamidul Islam for presenting his case. I request Hamidul Islam, please share your screen and start your presentation. And I request everyone, please have your question. You can send it to me on the chat box or directly have your question to the speaker and also the renowned participant. Okay. Hamidul Islam.
Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, sir. And please, hi. We can see your screen and you can please start. Go on, Hamidul Islam.
This is not moving. Why?
Better stop sharing and come from the first again. I think the computer system and all the network is exhausted because the webinar session all over the world is so much in number. Okay, then start share again.
Yes, I'm trying. But this is not working. Why? I don't know.
You have to come from the screen, not from the direct. Just share the first option of your share screen.
Yes.
If you first option, then you can start your screen sharing.
Amma deri kato.
Okay, click now.
But it's not working.
Okay, it is working. I advise you not to add the
Thank you very much, sir. Can you hear me?
Okay, you can start now, sir.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
Welcome you all to the basically the webinar session from Bangladesh Kurgan Fellowship Group. And today the topic is Ilizarov technique of TBL. And Dr. Mohammed Hamidullah presenting to the office. This is our group. And this is my professor, the mentor, and is a good advisor for us for becoming a Ilizarov surgeon. I respect you, sir, because you are the world, I think, greatest surgeon in the world. This is my center where I am working now. It's National Institute for Traumatology and Orthopedic Rehabilitation, NITOR, Dhaka, Bangladesh. And now introduction. TBA is the most common long bone fracture in the body. It is about 3.8% of all adult fracture, 40% of all limb fracture. Common is between 21 to 30 years. It occurs at any age. And male fall ratio is 6 to 1. Common mechanism rotator accident, about 40%. Among this 40%, about 78% due to motor vehicle collision. Most of the fractures are gastro-3-type fracture, and among all fractures, 69% of the patient underwent surgery. Fracture reduction by Ilizarov technique is essentially non-surgical method. except for insertions of some wires. And first, we must know the general rules for assembly should be learned, and the special variation, a special case must be learned. Indication would follow naturally. And anatomy. It is a very much important anatomy, because this is very important. Surgeon must have good knowledge about anatomy. And if you don't have knowledge about anatomy, surgery will be not surgery, surgical technique, and any other things should be difficult for us. So in short, I want to tell about the anatomy of the tibia. This is tibia anterior view, and this is posterior view, and this is proximal part, this is distal part, and this is midship. Roughly it has three border, anterior border, anterior medial border, anterolateral border, posteromedial border, and three surface. This is medial surface, lateral surface, posterior surface. There is a muscle attachment here, and it is very important that tibia in the anterior aspect and medial aspect, lateral aspect, only one muscle attachment is here. This tibial is anterior muscle. Whole bone is subcutaneous bone. So there is tons of very easy to wire insertion through the medial lateral surface. This is very important. We know because this is femoral artery, passes through the back of the distal part of the femur and distal part of the joint popliteal surface. This is very important here. After just few millimeter of the joint line, it's divided into two parts, anterior artery, and this is posterior artery. Anterior artery, after passing the intermuscular septum, it comes to lateral aspect of the leg. This is very important here. This arrow is indicating here. It comes the distal third of the leg. It comes at contact with the bone. So this is the dangerous area. While you passing the wire through this area, you must take care. It has three zones here. Abaris always told us the anterior, middle, and posterior zone. Middle zone is dangerous. So during passing wire, you must take care of this area. And another part is here that after passing the wire artery, so posterior medial aspect of the leg. In the distal part, it comes just behind the middle malleolus and postmedial border of the tibia. So during passing of the wire, one must take care that wire should pass just behind the middle malleolus. This anatomy is very important for the common nerve. This is the cytochondrial nerve, because in case of tibia fibula transfixation of the wire, this area must be kept in mind, because there is an injury of the common cranial nerve. So don't pass any wire. So this neck of the fibula, this is head of the fibula. It can easily palpate. And after palpating this head, you can insert the through this area, not this area. If you put pass through this area, every sense of injury of the common cranial nerve and ultimately foot drop will develop. This is a classification of fracture of the tibia. I think everyone will know about the classification. This is proximal one, proximal part. This is diaphyseal and distal part. And extra-articular fracture, there is partial articular fracture, complete articular fracture. And in diaphyseal, simple fracture, waist fracture, complex fracture, extra-articular fracture, partial articular fracture, and complex articular fracture, like proximal fracture. If you know a fracture pattern clearly, it will be easy for us for doing surgery. And safe zone, this is very important. This diagram demonstrates the medial and lateral axis of the tibia available for pin insertion. And we should keep in mind always for inserting wire, insertion wire. This is very easy to remember. It is divided into six zones, zone 1 to 6. And zone 1 is situated 1.5 centimeter from the joint line. This is zone 2, 78 centimeter. This is zone 3, this is 12 centimeter from the joint line. This is zone 4. This is the midpoint, just in midpoint between the ankle and knee joint. And this is the ankle zone 5. This is 12 centimeter from the articular margin of the tibia, lateral margin of the tibia. And this is the zone 6, 2 centimeter from the joint line. This is very important here. Regarding safe zone, this is very important. I already mentioned here before. Avoid transtibial fibula wire near the peroneal nerve at the neck of the fibula. This area is indicating again, this very important area, must keep in mind. And three types of wire can be inserted in the tibia, maybe transverse, maybe tibial fibula, maybe medial face. The basic principle of operative technique, exit and entrance site must be determined. This is very important. And it must be located 1.5 to 2 centimeters from the neurovascular bundle. And we must take care during passing out through the critical structure. And we must introduce the wire slowly. And skin must be supported by finger pressure to secure exact point of wire implantation. Loosely attached slotted fixation board at entrance side, very important. Sometimes we can do it. Loosely attached fixation board at the entrance point. Hide the K-wire and prevent deflection during introduction and drilling. And you must one wire, one hole to prevent incorrect positioning. One wire, one hole to prevent incorrect positioning. Push wire manually to the bone before drilling. Don't drill through the skin or muscle. Push the wire manually to the bone, then drilling. Wire to passing wire, each muscle should be stressed maximally to its functional length to maximize extraction of adjacent joint. My dear friend, this is very important because when we passing the wire, if you don't do this in the same in this manner, that is, if you want to pass the from the anterior side, you must plantarize the foot maximally to get maximum length of the adjacent ligaments and muscles. And if you want to pass the wire through the posterior aspect, you must dorsiflex the foot maximally to get the maximum length of the tendon. If you don't do this, there is some development of joint stiffness. Wire is drilled through bone to both cortex. This is very important, passing through bone canal and bone marrow transmitter. This is very important. Don't try to pass through like this one. If you try to pass through without medulla, without both cortex, without medullary cavity, there is the excessive heat production is there. So there is chance of loosening of the wire at the bone wire interface, and there is chance of osteomyelitis. So it's very important. And there are several types of laser wire. This is Prakash wire for cancellous bones, and this is bayonet wire for cortical bones, and sometimes olive oil you can use. And for stability, to wire crisscrossing at an angle as to close to 90 degree is required. So it is not possible every time, but we should keep in mind that if the angle is less than 30 degree, chance of side to side ring displacement. And if the angle is 30 to 45 degree, chance of ring sharing movement. So my dear friend, you must keep in mind this angle, about this angle. And this figure shows that wire should not be, if you pass through wire to the bones, wire is away from the ring, wire should not be brought to the ring, wire should not be brought to the ring, ring should be brought to the wire by using support like post or any hinges. And if we need greater load, we can use three or more wires transfixed to the bone. When wire is close to the ring connector, it bears small axial load. This is very important. And when it is away from the ring connector, it bears greater axial load, developing larger diameter in the hole. Stabilize the ring sometimes with the wire with the stopper, and if it's offside wire, that is why it's if wire is away from the ring, we can fasten it to the ring by support like post and other things. And this is very important, position of the wire in relation to hole of the ring. If the wire in the central position of the ring, then we can use centrally cannulated fixing board. If the wire is away from the center of the ring wire hole, we can use side cutting nut fixing board. And if it is between the hole, we can use another device of buckle and other things. A technique of wire bending, actually there are several techniques of wire bending. I have done in the Kurgan Center in different ways. Main thing is to first bend the tip of the 90 degree, then 90 degree, and then keep the tip of the wire in the hole or in the near to the ring, so it prevents stress or puncture of the physician and patient. And adequate tension is very much important. We know about tensioning. Range of tensioning is very important. This is 50 to 130 kg. It is, you must keep in mind that tensioning strength of wire of half ring is 50 to 70 kg, and tension strength of offset wire, that is if the wire is ever from the ring when supported by the support or any other things, the tension should be 50 to 80 kg. And tensioning below, last one, tensioning strength of the wire with Oliver stopper, this must be 100-110 kg. And SML ring fixture is very important. So there are some consideration, major consideration like that is stability of fixation of the frame to the bone, the prevention of gross bone fragment motion, ability to manipulate bone and to perform necessary fragment movement like straightening, bending, destruction, compression, rotation and combination of this movement. Construction of frame can be done in advance or during surgery. But in Kurgan Center, we have seen that they never construct the frame advance in the surgery. They always construct the frame during the surgery. And our SAR is also advised us for doing this construction as assembling during surgery. And we are also using this practice in this manner. An important aspect of frame assembly, there is some important point here. Ring positioning, ring inclination, ring orientation, ring level, space between skin and ring. This is, there are several types of ring here. That is main frame, supporting ring. This is main frame. It bears weight of the full construct. This should be situated 3 to 5 cm from the joint. And this last ring, this is very important. These two are basic ring, stabilizing frame supporting. This ring, this is called pulling pushing ring. It can be moved with the flexor, according to the flexor side or running on the side. And this is a reference ring. It corresponds to the apex of the bone angulation. It used as a reference ring for the pushing pulling ring or the stabilizing supporting frame ring. But what is the ring inclination? This is very important. Ring is position around the anatomic bone center of fixation. This must keep in mind. If we think this is the axial anatomical axial line, this is bones. Ring should be perpendicular and 90 degree with this axis. This is very important. Inclination of the ring should be perpendicular to the bone segment. If this is, there is minor inclination, there is 10 degree like that and like that. There is large derangement of the ring, the distal end. Ring orientation, rings at deeper level and in different inclination are oriented so that the connection of half rings must align on the same straight line. After connecting rings, arrives in parallel position to each other and bone fragments in good alignment. And the space between the skin and ring. At the narrowest gap, space of at least 3 cm should be maintained between inner curve of the ring and the skin. How can you achieve this? There are 3 ways. Limb measured in 2 plane, the largest diameter is considered, and add 6 cm to this diameter is provided to the size of the ring. This is one of the simple method. And another method is attach most anticipated size and seek a space of 3 cm. This is very easy. Don't difficult job, I think. Use plastic template, it's also easy. And regarding post-operative management, we know that after ring surgery, there are some edema, developed edema, swelling of the leg. So immediately after post, the first and second day, limb manifestation is very important. Protection of the wire skin interface, non-circular bandage. This is very important. Non-circular bandage, not the circular bandage. For incision and sterile dressing must be used. The first operative, the first week, sterile dressing. This may be daily or 1 day after fail or 3 days after fail. Active passive movement of the limbs is very important. Partial or full weight bearing according to the strength of the ring and condition of the fracture site. And physiotherapy must be started. After 1 week till removal, check for tensioning. It's very important because there is some sub-loosening of the wire. Look for a tight infection. This is very important. Knots and clamps tightness. This is very important. Sometimes when patient begins to start weight bearing, there is some sort of impedance of loosening of the knot. So we must take care knots and clamp tightening. If the wire is not as loose, there is some sort of ring disalignment and there is some sort of infection and dynamization tightening of the status of leather treatment. There's basically 2 phases, destruction compression phase and fixation phase. And it depends upon the 1 to 4 months, depending on the age of the patient, fracture size, compression, the fracture, etc. It is almost one to four months. And immobility and fixation phase, it is usually double of the compression fixation phase. And dynamization of the frame, 15 to 20 days prior to fixation removal, and period of immobilization with the cast of brace after removal of the frame. Very important. What is dynamization? When dynamization is done, satisfactory appearance of the regional calcification, complete decanalization, and formation of the cortex is seen. What to do for dynamization? Loosen the nerves at the site of connecting rod. Media friend is mentioning here, thus loosen the nerves at the site of the connecting rod. Very important. Purpose of dynamization. What is the purpose? Allow static fissure torque to distribute weight across the flexor site. As a result, elasticity of the callus decreases, bone stiffness and strength increases. Large axial dynamization helps to restore cortical contact and produce a stable flexor pattern with inherent mechanical support. So removal of the apparatus, what should be done? Dynamization of the apparatus, excess should be taken, and at least 3 cortices of 5 out of 4 before removal of the frame. Patient may be asked to use limb in a functional manner before cutting the wires. Tension of that must be removed. So some things, Professor Shagarov, one of the oldest men, one of the learned men in the Kurgan Center, how he is teaching us how to reduce the fracture, how to do assemble the frame. And there is some tips here. If the fracture is transverse fracture, then suitable for axial compression, only axial compression, this axial compression. If the fracture is oblique and there is side-to-side compression, if you give axial compression, there is overlapping the bone. So this is important, side-to-side compression. And if the fracture is like that one, that is oblique and transverse fracture, this combination of axial and side-to-side compression. And this diagram showed the level of the ring according to the side of the fracture. If the fracture is proximal, ring should be like that one. If distal third, ring should be like that one. And if it is mid-shaft, ring should be like that one. And frame assemble around the tibia and align parallel to the crest of the tibia in anterior plane. This is very important. I have mentioned here before. And sometimes an open section ring, that is 5/8 ring, open section ring can be used in the tibial mounting, the proximal part, to give movement of the knee joint. And the example is here, how can we reduce a fracture? Say this is a fracture, oblique fracture is there. It is coronal plane view. And how can you reduce? First, we will have to give traction. If the fracture, recent fracture, we give adequate traction, almost all fracture is reduced within 10 to 15 degree. So, thus put the wire here with the parallel to the joint line and here, parallel to the joint line. Don't try to put wire here first, don't reduce the fracture first. Then tension the wire fixed to the ring. Tension the wire fixed to the ring. And assembly of the other rings with the rod, then put one olive from that side. And if you tension the olive from that side, that will reduce. There is some displacement in another view, like sagittal view. If there is displacement, we can put an olive in the arch fashion. Say we should not, passing through the olive, we should not fix in the hole here. We will fix the arch just some few hole above the hole. This is not desired hole, just above the hole. And if we don't tighten the knot before taking the knot, we give tension from the side and we keep tension gradually. This will come in aligned, the pressure will reduce, and then tighten the knot and tension is completed. And this is the final. Sometimes insertion of two olive wires from opposite side perpendicular to flexor line. This is important in case of proximal tibia, there is condylar flexor is there. So if we put olive wire from that side and one from that side, this is a balanced traction. If we use two dynamometer or do two traction tension set, if we give traction, the flexor will reduce nicely. And experience from Kurgan Center, this is from the Kurgan, Russia. This is the preoperative X-ray. They always do the X-ray in that manner. They don't use the CM machine. They have nice radiological department is in every floor of the operation theater, before doing the surgery, they put wire in the position where ring should be placed, and then take the X-ray. And this is traction set. They are using the nice traction set, simple maneuver. They are doing the traction set in the Korean center. This is the operation room. How nice, how sterile the operation. Some of us have the thinking that in-room surgery is a semi-sterile. No, not like that. See the condition of the operation field to the surgeon. This is the ring after fixation of the ring. See that space nicely maintained in the anterior, middle, lateral space. And this is after doing the surgery, post-operative X-ray. Then adequate tensioning of the wire. Ring inclination is nice. Orientation is nice. The segment. This is our experience from Bangladesh. This is a proximal tibia fracture. But in AP view, it may look simple, but in the oblique view, the parietal section is long oblique fracture from this anterior aspect to posterior aspect. So this is very unstable fracture. Very interesting case. Why should be the ring should be placed? How ring should be placed? How many rings should be placed? This is long oblique fracture. And what we have done? First we fix the proximal ring and the distal ring. After fixing these two ring, we use olive oil from that side and from that side. And after fixing these two ring, we construct the ring assemble without passing the wire. If the ring is good aligned with the axis of the bone, that is the connecting nerve of the two half ring, if it is good and aligned, in the case of the iliac crest, then it is easy to manage the fracture. And we have just passed to Oliver from that one from that side and not from that side, and give traction, and so there is no gap now between the fracture. Nicely reduce the fracture, and there is well tensioning of the wire. There is bending in the wire end here. I think assembly is nice. I think this is another case. Difference, we have hold the distal femur here. Why you have hold the distal? Some it is there is a study to hold the. If you think that there is the stability is less by using only the one ring to proximal fragment, then you can fix that femur and you can remove this thing 3 to 6 weeks after fixation. And if you think that this is stable enough, this ring is stable enough, you cannot use the distal femoral ring. This is post-operative X-ray, the removal of the fixator. This is another case. This is distal tibia fracture. There is postmedial displacement of the proximal fragment. So how can we reduce this fracture? It's very easy. First, you fix the proximal ring and distal ring. Then put all two oliver from opposite direction in the desired plane. If you can put the oliver desired plane and opposite direction, it's easy to manage the fracture. This is nicely reduce the fracture. This is postoperative X-ray. This is appropriate. Union is going on. This is another case. This is a mid-shaft fracture. There is a large waist fracture. This is a butterfly fragment here. So we did the same thing. We first fix the proximal ring, then the distal ring, then put olive from opposite side. But we do not hold this fragment. If you think the fragment is unstable enough, unstable, it because not enough, then you can hold this fragment to make it stable. But if you think the fracture is reduced, well stabilized, you cannot hold this the wire. This is post-operative X-ray. This is after removal of the frame. This is another open case. This case, there is a unilateral monoaxial fissure is there. Why I'm telling you about this fissure and why telling about the case? It is very important that if the fracture line is aligned and good aligned, it's put in position after fixing with monoaxial fixator, and if we want to do surgery later on, we should keep in situ. We should keep it. Don't remove the fixator. If you remove the fixator, after 1 month, this will make us malignant of the fracture. So if you keep in situ, we can fix this fixator like that one. And this is the post-operative X-ray. And this is after removal of the fixator. So there's an advantage of this technique. Minimal invasive, relatively easy application, allow deformity to be corrected in three dimensions. Patient is mobile throughout the course of the pain. Early physiotherapy prevents joint stiffness and contracture. Bone grafting is unnecessary. A simple hardware can be removed. And different there are some disadvantages, mechanical and biological. Destruction of the fracture site, pain bone interface failure, bulky frame, refracture, instability of the apparatus, breaking of or loosening of the long learning curve. Biological disadvantage, pin tag infection, neurovascular injury, thinning of the muscles, soft tissue contracture, pain, demand, joint stiffness, and osteolysis. And different there is a complication, early complication, neurovascular complication, maybe injured during the surgery. Community fracture of osteomotorized bone, local skin tightness, psychological incompatibility. Or the late complication, pin site infection, pain at osteotomy site during and later on. Soft tissue contracture and joint stiffness, osteoporosis, reflex sympathetic dystrophy, progression of angular deformity and creation of new one after fixator removal, limb swelling, non-union of premature consolidation, lengthening site and joint subluxation. So thank you very much. This is like a tibia. We are 7 friends here. We are in all an aligned, but this guy is a little bit from our side, like varus deformity, but we have lot of my biocompatible lawyer, thin wire, MLA bowler in our hand. So it is not a matter for us to keep him in the position like he is our technique. So don't try to go from the line. If you go from the line, you'll fall in danger. So always keep yourself in the line. So you stay at home, stay safe during the COVID pandemic zone. Thank you very much for patience here.
Arif, unmute your microphone.
Thank you, Hamdi Uslam, for a nice presentation, especially your last slide. You have to adhere to one technique, that is the Elizarov technique. And if you adhere Elizarov technique, you will not be derailed. You always be in line. And now I request you to please stop your screen share so that we can go to the next presentation. And I request everyone, please have your question, and we will go directly to the question answer session just after the presentation. And now I am going to Kamruzzaman. Kamruzzaman, can you hear me, sir?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Please share your screen and be careful about time so that we can have good interaction at the end of presentation. And you know that yesterday we have a great presentation from Junjunwala sir, so that one session was just rescheduled. And today, I think if you learn from two different masters, you can learn many things. So just we combined the two lecture today and just have our session today. And Kamruzzaman, you can proceed, sir.
Thank you very much, Dr. Arif. And thank you, Bari sir, and all Kurgan fellow and all participants to give me the opportunity to present here. I am welcome you all to Zoom PowerPoint presentation on basic Elizarov technique. Today's topic is Elizarov technique in tibia. I am working as a assistant professor, orthosurgery department of Mayamshing Medical College Hospital. Yesterday, we have published topics on Elizarov, the Elizarov external fixator for the treatment of gap non-rotating mid-shaft tibia fibula fracture in Mayamshing Medical College Journal. Here we give the message to reduce the cost and repeated surgical intervention in case of primary open fracture tibia fibula. Many times we fix the uniaxial fixator that is going to 2 to 3 months. There is a gap. So it should be replaced by Elizarov external fixator rather than continuing the treatment. This is the message. And I also respect my all teachers, especially Professor Barisar, to introduce us this Elizarov technique. This is the content of this today's lecture. I also grateful to Dr. Hamidul Islam to elaborately and nicely produce his lecture just now. The basic generalization, and use basis for reasoning or conduct. But technique is a practical method applied to the some particular tasks. I think you know, all you know. And I add something, the tibia word comes in flute, that means a tube-shaped musical instrument for its tubular shape of the tibia. And it plays an important role in the body mechanics because it is larger of the two leg bone, responsible for more than 80% body weight bearing for lower extremity, and vital for proper knee and ankle joint motion. And it is the most fractured long bone in the human and most vulnerable part in its shape. So tibia has many unique fracture in different parts of its whole length. So there is many complication. And its medial border is subcutaneous, so more prone to fracture and limited blood supply, especially in its distal end. So more susceptible to more soft tissue damage, infection, wound breakdown, and finally there is a non-union. And Elizarov method is a useful adjunct in the orthopedic armamentaria in all type of tibia fracture because it is minimally invasive and better alternative to invasive procedure like open reduction internal fixation of the tibia fracture by plate screw or nail. It permits secondary correction after surgery without further intervention, even without OT facilities. Infection following fixation with nail and plate can be effectively managed with Elizarov fixator. And sometimes alternative to amputation of the limbs. And some advantages already described. I only think it is the only method, I think immediate weight bearing is possible in this method. Secondary trophic ulcer can be healed without the graft. And it is a simple hardware removal comparison to the internal fixation device. And it is reduced the treatment time and cost, disability payment significantly. And for the treatment fracture and post-operative non-union, primary disability decreased by 3 to 5 times and 8-fold compared with traditional method in case of open fracture. So patient return to the work sooner, that is advantageous to the economy of the country. And some indication in traumatology, comminuted intra-articular or open fracture, non-union, malunion. It can be therapeutic and cosmetic elongation, and deformity correction may be congenital, may be acquired, and arthrodesis and arthrodiastasis. Now come to the procedure in general. Wire passed percutaneous through the bone by a drill, and protruding ends of the wires are fixed to the ding with fixation bolt and nuts. That rings encircle the limb and tension wire to enhance the stability. These rings are connected and fixed to the one another by threaded rod with nuts. In case of tibia, ideal bone construct is 4 rings connected to each other and wire crossing the 90 degree and transfixed to the tubular cortical bone. So tibia is divided into 3 parts, proximal, medial, and distal, because of specific tissue involvement in different part. So we consider the preoperative examination in case of tibia fracture, knee ligament injury, or ankle range of motion, skin or abrasion, or it is open fracture. It is considered the compartment syndrome or distal sensation and pulse. And in case of radiograph, we see the length of the space between the tibial plateau and fracture, and fracture, and also the tibial plafond, and length of the fracture, and associated fibula fracture or not. And we do the templating because of measurement of opposite limb extremity for the ring size. We can measure the opposite limb and two finger breadth of clearance all around. And actually, tibia is more spaces in posteriorly than anteriorly. And space between the two inner ring, it must be more than the length of the fracture combination. And in case of proximal or distal fracture, consider need for the lower thigh or foot inclusion respectively. And frame reconstruction. Ring are positioned in the same plane and bolt and nuts and got together. Typically four ring assemble, two in the proximal of the fracture and two in the distal to the fracture, if possible. And most proximal ring in the tibia, you can use open section 5/8 ring attached to the full ring because of allowing the maximum flexion and provides two level fixation. And two rings are used on large fragment in case of a large fracture. And drop post used in the smaller fragment. You see the here is the using the drop post by a male post. And two proximal and distal rings are connected by a rod with appropriate length. It should be keep in mind that the fracture length of the fracture and rod of the fracture rod length is more than length of the fracture. And this is the first design Elizarov ring situated in the Kurgan Museum, preserved in the Kurgan Museum. And now come to the threaded rod. Initially, only one single long anterior and posterior threaded rod used to connect each other, because that we can get the plenty of space medially and laterally to wire insertion. Once the fixation is complete, then the place the two additional rod, the four rod is complete. And plane for fracture site compression. If the sufficient span in the fracture site, you can compress easily. So configure the frame accordingly. And in case of proximal tibia fracture in a 5/8 ring mounted top of the complete ring, we said earlier, it can be positioned just below the joint line or at the level of the fibular head, so allow the knee flexion. Or in case of use the full ring, it can be at the level of the fibular head, proximal ring. So surgical strategy is the preliminary reduction of the fracture site. You can hold the reduction by cross wire. And insertion of the transverse proximal and distal wire perpendicular to the knee and ankle joint line. And application of the frame and tensioning of the proximal and distal wire. There is an important thing keep in mind is the ring brought to the wire using the washer. If the ring is apart from the wire, you can use the washer and post, but don't try to wire not brought to the frame. And in case of distal fracture, with minimal plafond displacement, three sets of ring we used. One is the just above the plafond, one is the proximal tibia, and one other is the calcaneum. Now come to the position of the patient. If possible, in supine. Fine position and siam come from the opposite side. In case of large hip bump and a sterile foot bump is possible with the support of the knee, you can space more space. And you achieve the reduction by traction. And when you apply the frame, like open a book, you open the frame and place the leg. And coupling the bolt align over and parallel to the crest of the tibia to see the rotation and ensure the proper clearance with at least one finger breadth anteriorly and two finger posteriorly. This is for the only tibia. In case of coronal wire and frame attachment, proximal coronal plane reference wire, you can use the reference wire. Wire is placed at label and parallel to the knee joint and mark. And one wire is placed to the approximately 1 centimeter below the joint line and mark. In case of distal coronal plane wire, you place prior to the remaining proximal wire, and one wire placed to the transverse to the ankle joint and mark, and frame it as to the proximal and distal wire. So this is the proximal ring and distal ring. In case of mid-shaft fracture, if residual fracture displacement, olive wire can be inserted from opposite side of the fracture, perpendicular to the fracture plane, and tension until the fracture is reduced. You see the issue here. And remaining proximal wire, medial face wire. If you inserted from the posterior medial side, to the anterolateral side, if you have to flexing the knee to avoid the face anserinus. Remaining distal wire, you have to ensure the proper rotational alignment by the measuring the tibial tubercle to bimalar axis on the normal leg to assess the rotation of the fracture. And ring remain the centralized, and you have to ensure the fracture should be reduced. And finally, the remaining wire attached to the remaining ring. This is the frame construction going on, distal and these two middle. And final frame, after tensioning of the wall wire, you can first this C fracture and final this fracture site. Now come to the post-operative management. It is very much important because of it is nothing but extension of the surgical procedure and needs the same high level care and monitoring that apply the during actual surgery. In case of femoral, calcaneal wire, remove the you can remove it in 6 weeks and range of motion has started. We can see that in postoperatively pain relief, limb position, neurological examination, pin site infection, stability of the frame, some ambulatory or not, and follow-up X-ray, and quality of bone regenerated. Physiotherapy, it is very much important in Elizarov technique. Excellent surgery, but result may be poor because lack of the proper physiotherapy. So patient have to attend proper program of exercise, mobilization, and ambulation is mandatory. In Elizarov, original technique requires the patient to stay in hospital and participate in various forms of therapy at least 2 hours per day. I think in our subcontinent that is not possible whole time, but it is better to stay hospital and participate of this physiotherapy. Now come to the removal of the apparatus. 1 month too late is better than a day too early. X-ray shows the three cortexes, anterior and lateral view, fully ossified with sharp outline and cortical wound. You can remove. Before final removal of the apparatus, a stress test should be done for axial loading to bone for the 15 to 20 days before, and asked to use the limb in functional manner, wide bearing from the upper limb, or functional manner of the lower limb and functional manner of the upper limb. If the patient is able to do these activities in the frame, can be removed with confidence. And yet it should be removed under general or spinal anesthesia. Now we are going to some case illustration. This is the open comminuted fracture tibia gastrulus 3A. This is the fracture reduced nicely and healed nicely. And this soft tissue is healed. Only use the Elizarov, no skin grafting. This is the open comminuted fracture tibia fibula gastrulus 3B. You see the medial cortex of the tibia is 180 degrees rotated. We can do nothing, only apply the Elizarov, and there is a heal of the bone with this method, and patient is going well. And this is the another segmental fracture of the tibia. We use the two ring in the middle segment, and now the fracture is more probably healed. This is the another segmental fracture with the diabetic patient who use only the limb, no internal surgery like that. This is uniting with some translation. Now come to the tibial plateau fracture. It is goal of treatment is the stable, well-aligned, mobile, pain-free joint and minimal risk of post-traumatic osteoarthritis. And this is the case from Kurgan Center. They use the reference wire also, as they use the already Dr. Hamidul said that they use the only X-ray mostly, and there is a traction, and use this method, and this is the final X-ray. And also the distal tibial fracture reduced nicely. This is the distal tibial fracture. And this is the distal third fracture. This is the healed only with the Elizarov, and there is also some fibular osteotomy. And this is the use of wire in the fibula to maintain the length. And this is also this case, distal third of tibia fracture, open. And so every method has some complication. Two complication is mainly most common complication, loosening and pin track infection, thermal injury. And also chronic osteomyelitis is only 4% reported, nerve and vessel injury. And this is the nice view of the Kurgan Center. This patient is try to hold me like this way, or if he is pain free, I like that more. So lastly, we take the home message. The Elizarov method is the golden and trusted method for all bones, especially tibia. We need a life boat or life jacket during our journey. So Elizarov method is the life boat or life boat technology for the orthopedic surgeon. Without the Elizarov, you cannot manage the fracture, especially tibia. You have to refer the patient to someone if you not accustomed with the technique of the tibia. So finally, we say that don't violate the basic principle of Elizarov. You can modify the technique according to need. And thank you very much. Before I concluding this, I draw attention to the picture of this lady is the just smiling behind the patient. This is the speech of doctor, nothing more. So thank you for patience hearing, Dr. Arif.
Yes, sir. Thank you for your brilliant presentation. Every time we go through any presentation, we learn many things new. And there are very tremendous number of information we get from your lecture. And always you are trying to get, you're trying to deliver everyone a very new way of learning. So thank you, Jaman. And especially thank to also Hamidul Islam. Because both the senior surgeon from Bangladesh, Hamidul Islam and Kamrul Jaman, they share their case, how nicely they done the Elizarov. Now I am going to the participation view so that we can have a good interaction. And as you know that today we have the two presentations. So for interaction, we will go directly to question answer session. Just after the end of screen sharing, I will go to the Mufakkal Bari sir for overall comments over the two sessions. And after that, we will go directly to the question answer session. There are many questions, just they send it to me for their answering. And I think any participant can ask the question. And any participant can ask the question. And now you know that the OrthoTB group is trying their best for making the session in live telecast in OrthoTB. So far, Samsulata sir tried, and now the another authority, Dr. Ashok Shyam, you know him because he is frequently connected with us in a previous session. He is trying to make it live. So I think now the host status is delivered to them. And now I requesting Ghulam Mustafa and Nazmul Huda Sethu, you can do some technical job to unmute anyone or mute anyone, as because I am not the host now. And now I am going to Mufakkal Bari sir. Can you please unmute and have some comment to the overall session? Mufakkal Bari sir, are you here, sir?
Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. We can hear you. Sir.
Yes. Yes. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, all my friends from my country and from Nigeria, from India and from Nepal, all the time they are attending. So I'm very much happy that two of my students, Hamid and Kamlu Jaman, they have presented very, very nicely. But I have some observations. Why observations? I must tell them this one, because for the long time I'm working with Elizarov, and from my experience, a little bit, they've wonderfully, what I have seen, 5 cases shown by Hamid, beautifully wire tension, placement of the ring, and I loved it. Only one thing is that, I must tell this one, wire tensioning was very good, but you should have to pay attention regarding the bending of the wires, the 2 fingers you are cutting, so that you cannot destroy your cloths, your bits. Even if you put your ring like this, nothing will be here. Nothing will be filled. You must feel that this whole side of the whole ring is beautiful. No blankets, no cloths. And I have shown this to Nazmul Huda Sethu. Probably he knows, and Hamid also, I've seen some of the cases. And regarding the very simple, what is the advantage of Elizarov and what is the disadvantage of Elizarov? Advantage 4, customizable. This is customizable advantage, you know, customizable, modular. Can treat multi-level, multi-plellar deformities and can articulate across the joint. These are the advantage. Disadvantage only 2. Other things are complications. You can overcome little bit complications. Complications in your life, when you stay, when you do something in your life, you'll face a lot of complications, not only in Izarov, in your whole life also. A disadvantage to one is bulky. Another is get a learning steep. I am doing for the last, now it is going since 82. Still I'm learning a lot of things in Elizarov. You just calculate. So get a learning steep or get a learning curve. And I am telling all my friends here, you please learn Elizarov. Don't think this, you can do whatever you like from here to here. And forget about this from here to here. In TVA, very easy. Randomly, you can put different sides. When you'll pass 5 years, 10 years, then you'll be able to understand what I can do. By wire technique, you can, which disease, not only trauma. Yes, rightly shown, both of you, beautiful cases. And rule of two. You know that, I want to repeat it for my junior colleagues. 2 wires, 2 fingers, 2 fixation level. So, as a rule, use smaller rings for more stability. Use larger rings whenever necessary. Whenever you see there is a edema, loss of that, you can use bigger size rings. And for you, dear friends, to be a good Elizarov surgeon, don't forget, always keep a measuring tape in your pocket. 1 box wrench and 1 wrench. 2. And goniometer, put here all the time. And you must have patience, devotion and dedications. These are the things, if you keep it in your mind all the time, you must be sincere. Every day you will have to check your wires. Proper wire tensioning is very important. Forget about the shunts, what Western world do only with the wires. This is called, that's why, transosseous osteosynthesis. If you put pins, you can put that. You cannot say this is Elizarov. It is a modification of Elizarov, hybrid. Yes, in Kurgan Center also, in the upper fema, they are using. In the humerus also using, not word bearing. But loading, whenever you are applying load, fundamental principle, I always tell, load and motion. Micro motion increases circulation. Then you will have a very, very good regenerate bone. So these are my observations, and regarding the, there are lots of secrets and tricks. Lots of secrets and tricks in one lecture, two lecture, even 10 lectures, you cannot find everything. It's still coming out lot of things. So learn, you know, before learning Elizarov, you just take one book and read how many external fixators in the world are now. Oganisyan, well-known. Shivash, well-known. Hoffman, well-known. Then a lot of Studer, lot of external fixtures, man, they have created. But the biological parameters give Elizarov, nobody showed. And that biological parameters, on the basis of that, SUB, Taylor's, everything is going on. So, dear my junior friends and students, this Hamid, and I'm very happy that you are trying and doing very good. And within a few days, you will be very strong Elizarov surgeon. And whenever you rings and wires in your hand, solve any problem. Don't worry, I tell you, this is from my life. Don't believe the others. This is from my life that I'm doing. Those who have got Shetu for the last 10 years is coming to me. He knows what I'm doing. And I have the documentation. You must keep documentation all the time. What you do, that he has published. If you don't documentation, nobody will believe you. Nobody will believe you. I have done, sir, 20,000 cases. Show me, no documentation, nobody will believe you. But keep documentation. These are the main things. Thank you very much that I have given you some instructions, advice that is for your life. All the time. Elizarov surgeon must have patience. Orthopedic surgeon must have patience. This is not that you are putting your stomach like pain, giving you, no. You are regenerating new bone. You're giving your life to the patient. So patience is the very important, devotion, dedication, honesty, and you will be able to fulfill your target. Thank you very much. Okay. In course of question, I will answer if needed.
Thank you, sir, for your nice words. Every time you are so inspiring, and we always keep in our mind about your learning, that always try to bring the tapes and the spanner and the box rings in our pocket. And this is like always we feel like a Elizarov surgeon. And especially when our mentor praises us on our words, it will increase our encourage a very thousand times. And so that I see that the Jaman and Hamidul Islam, they are smiling, and I think congratulate them for their brilliant Elizarov technique and always maintaining the Kurgan principle. We are going to question answer session, but I think I have to go to Amir Hussain sir, because he is our senior professor. We need some comments from him, then I will go to the question answer session. As because time is running short, we will be in hurry. Amir Hussain sir, please unmute your microphone and have some comments, short comments, sir. Amir Hussain sir, can you hear me, sir?
Oh, yes.
Yes, sir. Please make some short comments.
Thank you, Dr. Kamrujaman and Hamidul Haq, because they are doing well. And I think that tibia is the most accessible bone, and all problem of the tibia can be solved by Elizarov technique. And the most common problem, especially in the open fracture, we are facing problem nowadays every day for the tibia problem in the non-union, in the open fracture, and so on. So tibia is the best soluble problem by Elizarov in I think. I thank also Professor as I attend today's your lecture in the morning. And your presentation is very well, and thank you as there are so many international faculties out there from India, from Masri, Mysore also. Thank you. And there is a lot of problem you are telling Dr. Zaman and also Hamidul. They are working by Elizarov, and also I tease Mr. Kamruzzaman also, and Elizarov, he is working with us for a long day in the NITOR.
Thank you, sir.
Also, thank you, Dr. Hamidul Haq. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir, for your nice words. And I just have an announcement that we have two co-hosts, Nazmul Huda Sethu and the Ghulam Mustafa. I will go back to you at the end of the session, and please participate in the question answer session. And if you want to add anything, you can add. And regarding Barisar comments about the how the wire should be oriented around the ring, when I was working with Barisar, I see that Barisar put his hand over the ring and just make it encircle around the ring and just say, look, there is no thing is a pinching in your hand. So that the ring and all the things should be so arranged that there is no hurting to patient another limb or any bed materials and other things. And also you should use the cover in postoperative care so that when the patient goes outside, he can use this nicely looking cover, and it will prevent it from the dust also. And regarding the wire bending, there are several techniques of wire bending. For wire bending, you should keep in mind, you may need fuser tension. You may need to tighten the nut, and you may need to extend the K wire also. So keeping all the things in mind, you should do your friendly technique for the wire bending. You may bend the wire opposite to the wire freezing bolt, but it will cause a problem. Sometimes you may need to tighten the nut. If the wire bending is over the nut, usually it makes problem before tightening. If you make a smooth curve bending, it has an advantage as that you can extend this smooth curve wire bended wire very nicely, so that you can put tension with tension or with later on. Every type configuration have some problems and some advantage and disadvantage. So we can focus on this issue on the another session. And now I am going to the question answer session. And there is a question from Dr. Shofi Zaman. That Shofi Zaman. Okay, am I right? Yes. He is just interested about the safe zone. For his information, we divide the safe zone into the four lecture, and every lecture is uploaded in the YouTube. You know that our YouTube is Elizarov Clinic, KUMC and Ortho World. You can go and through this lecture, and you can all have the safe zone. And there is a question to me in WhatsApp to Dr. Hamidul Islam. Sometimes in TBI, we got that the TBI is look like bow shaped or a boat shaped in the ring. Little anterior border is little bit curvy. When you looking sideward in the just after fixation in the operative room, sir, how can we manage this type of difficulties? Sometimes the anterior sag is there during the Elizarov ring fixation. Question to Hamidul Islam, sir.
Yes, Dr. Arif, can you hear me?
Yes, sir, I can hear you, please.
Question is that if there is sagging, anterior posterior sagging.
Anterior sagging.
The sagging.
The curve is the directed concave side is anterior and convex side is posterior. Sometimes the sheen is just sag.
Posterior.
You got that?
We can manage it in different ways. As for if you think that if your I have told it, you will not fix the bone, fix the brain fixated out with the anatomical axis of the bone, there is a chance of bowing or displacement of the fracture site. And after that, if you see that there is displacement still now is there, so there are several techniques to correction the bowing. Say if it's convex the posterior side, if you can distract the anterior rod, there is chance of correction is there. Or if you are doing X, if you see that there is angulation, you can put the hinge in the correct position and you can correct this convexity or concavity, I think, nicely.
Thank you, sir. I want to add one more thing is that this type of phenomena is usually happen during our Elizarov fixation in tibia. Sometimes if you just in the operative room, you see that from the lateral side, there is the tibia and the medial shaft of the tibia, there is a sag. It is a very common problem. And if you align your fragment in consideration with the distance from the bone length with the rod, I already showed you in the different lecture, a reduction technique. If the bone distance from the rod or ring is always equal, usually this type of sags do not happen. But sometimes when you do a traumatic case or any asymmetric limb swelling case, sometimes this type, you may have seen this type of sag, a different asymmetry in the ring with the limb. But in that case, you should do a X-ray to see how the bones are aligned. If these bones are not aligned correctly, then you may undo it in the later time. So basic principle is that you must put the rings and rods a equal distance from the anatomical axis. And if Nazmulullah Shetu want to add to how to you can prevent this type of problem, you can add. Nazmulullah Shetu.
Oh, can you hear me?
Yes, sir, I can hear you.
Okay, thank you. At first, I give congratulations to Dr. Kamrul Jaman and Dr. Hamidul Islam. And thank you for their nice presentation. And I think it is very much helpful for us and also for the beginners who want to do the Elizarov. The question is how we will correct the sagging position. Sagging, I share my experience. I want to just what I follow. At first, from very beginning, for the proximal fragment, when we set the rings, at least two rings, at first I draw a line over the shin from the center of the patella to the through the shin. It is a straight line and horizontal to the horizontal plane in the bed. Then we assemble the two rings in same plane. And then the third ring assembled and the last ring assembled. And then we go to the last ring and keep it in anatomical position and as far as possible in reduced position. Then we fix the distal ring with one wire. Then we see the then we do some sort of distraction. Then we go for the third ring fixation. If there is any sagging, I think then wire is some lifted to the upper hole, and we then check with the X-ray or initial. Then I will correct this. In this way, I just correct the sagging position.
Thank you, sir.
Can I understand?
Yes, sir. We got your ideas. And the main principle is that you have to read the geometry of the fracture very precisely before doing an operation. Because what you see in the limb is, you can see outside is like a normal limb manner, but the bones may be displaced in the limb. So if you follow the only surface marking of the limb, you may displace the bones. You have to go the surface marking of the bones details. That is the anterior sheen or anterior line. In that way, you can prevent this type of displacement and other thing. And one thing is most important that if you want to correct anything with the olive, you should keep the olive and the wires less frequent. If you got my idea, if you put a olive end wire in a ring, and if you just fasten both the wires in the in a ring, and after that, if you tighten or if you tension the olive, you will not displace or you will not navigate the bones. In this case, if you want to connect with the olives, you must keep free the other wires after the reduction of the bone fragment. After reduction of the bone fragment by olive, you can put the lifted wire fastened with the ring, and then you can get the tension in that wire. In this way, you can very precisely use the olives to do this type of correction. And another question is to me in my WhatsApp. To Kamrujaman. Kamrujaman, as you gave a lecture on the wire tensioning and wire technique, and it was a very interesting lecture. It is a question is that what is the biophysiological property of the wire that is computed for the Elizarov technique? What will be the biomechanical properties of the wire? How should be it elastic, or it should be very steep, or what will be the composition of this wire? If you have any comments on this this wire properties, you can add. Yes, Jaman, you get that question, Jaman? Dr. Jaman, you get that question?
Yes.
What is the physical property of a wire, Elizarov wire? Ideal physical property.
It is a thin biocompatible. It is a thin bio. Can
yes.
you hear me?
Yes, sir. We can hear you. Please.
It is a thin biocompatible wire. If the wire thickness, if it is pointed, it is sharp. It is sharpened and pointed, so it is decrease the thermal necrosis during the insertion in the body. Compatible, it is tightened. When it is
Yes. Arif.
Sorry.
I want to add something with this.
Yes, sir.
Add?
Just a minute. Jamal, sir, do you want to add anything? Then I will go to the Nazmul Huda, sir, and at the last to Bari, sir. What will be the ideal property of a wire? Like the Russian Elizarov center wire and our wire, what is the difference? Just make a comparison.
Lot of difference.
Yes.
Sir, you please continue.
Yes, sir. Dr. Arif.
Yes, sir.
Actually, in Kurgan Center,
yes,
what
sir?
We saw there, the why it is biocompatible. The wire is 1.5 or 1.8. Why not 3 millimeter or 4 millimeter? This is the question. And why it is malleable or flexible? Why this is so smooth? These are the questions regarding the biocompatible. One thing is it is very smooth, and its diameter is very very less invasive, and it does not cause any trauma to the soft tissue or bones, actually. And it is flexible, and it tolerates the tension about 1 kg weight, but we give here one maximum 130 kg. And this allow the micro motion, but above this diameter, above 1.8 or 2.5 or 3 millimeter, that does not allow the flexibility, that does not allow the load bearing, and there is no micro motion, and this also cause the myofasciitis, that is also joint movement and also muscle contraction problem. And there is also a chance of infection at the site of insertion. There are a lot of problems.
Yes, sir.
That's why we call it, it's a biocompatible or biological wire as well. Sir, please add.
Yeah, thank you, sir. I am going to Mufakkal Bari, sir.
Okay.
Sir, please compare, contrast the wire.
Hey, can I clarify this?
Yes, sir, please. I am going to you, sir.
Listen, I have a lecture probably biomechanics of the Elizarov external fixator.
Yes, sir.
I will explain there. Why Elizarov more stable than others? Why? Why? Because they are using the wires. Flexible. Have you seen the wires of you can make it full? This is so much flexible. 1.5, 1.8 and 2 mm they are using. Not more than that. And there is a yield point. What is yield point? What is yield point? If you cross 150 kg per day, that will break. That is yield point. Yield point. But here in Elizarov wire, we are telling all the time this is K wire. But they are using Elizarov wire. Everybody is now habituated for going K wire. The flexibility and elasticity of the Elizarov wire much more better than the wire that we are using in my country and in India. That's why this is called, I'm telling you all the time, branch osseous. What are the properties of the bone? Bone properties and so. What are the properties of the bone? Isoelastic, hydrostatic, pneumatic. What are the properties of the bone? These are the properties of bone. These properties of the bone is coincides with the properties of the elasticity of the wires, Elizarov wires. And if you think about the bending process, stability, the wires, this is Elizarov wires, you are getting more stability rather than rigidity. When you are going for pins, you are getting rigidity, not the flexibility. This is the I'll details talk on biomechanics of the Elizarov fixer on that day. Then you'll be able to understand. So I will be using in there 1.5, 1.8, and 2 mm. 2 mm for the healthy person. I'm using the Russians. These are all Russians. Chetun knows. Even the olive and the wires.
Thank you, sir, for your nice comments.
Thank you.
It is an interesting discussion, and Professor Barisa told us that he will discuss it on the biomechanics chapter. So we'll go to the another topics, but just I want to add two or three more things on the wire. Just think about the difference from the composition, difference from the physical property, difference from the future biochemical reaction property of the wire. All the time we should use the proper properties, proper characteristics of wire. Otherwise, we cannot get the good result. So, sir will tell us many about this thing on the later on. And there is a question from
Rashid. Adikulle.
Sorry, sir. Okay, I'll go to the Adikulle, sir. Later on, there is a question sent to me in WhatsApp from the Rashid Sunani. Rashid Sunani, are you here? I think he just sent me the question. And okay, question is to Dr. Jaman. Dr. Jaman, please unmute your microphone. Sir,
yes.
Sometimes we found that there is the break in the wire in the frame. What will be our strategy? We will replace the wire or just do the other thing? If any wire is break down, what will our strategy will be?
Thank you for a nice question. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Sometimes we use the now are using the more wire. Two wire. Actually, we use the two wire in the one ring. And sometimes we now are using the three wire in one ring. If the three wire he is using the three wire in one ring. If the one wire is broken, two wire may be sufficient for wire bearing. In case of only two wire is used and it is not in consolidation phase, so he have to replace the wire broken wire. You have to replace the broken wire.
Thank you, sir. We got the answer. The answer is that Barisar yesterday to one session told us that he used to put the three wires in ring whenever it is necessary. Then if one broke down, and other two will give you the support. But if you put the two wires, if one broke down, somebody just try to fasten this broken wire a different way to the ring again. But my advice is that please, usually who is the wire is broken and patient come late to your, usually the wire tact is also loosened. So you have to put the new wire if only on wire in that ring. And there are questions in the message box from the from why not put Elizara primarily in the tibia than uniaxial X-fix. I think this question goes to Hamidul Islam. Please unmute and have your comments about sometimes we put uniaxial and sometimes we put Elizara primarily. What is your opinion regarding these two methods?
Yes, opinion. Thank you for your very nice question. Actually, it depends upon the where you're doing the surgery. If the patient comes to my chamber, and if it is feasible for me, that will must go for Elizara the first time, no doubt. Regarding the patient, first and any other things. If the patient in the hospital, I think everybody will know that there is some limitation doing surgery in the first session, first time, because apparatus isn't available in that area, and also experts of surgery is not available of that area. So, to do the surgery primarily in the tibia or any other bones in the first situation. So I think it is better to do primarily the first time before. If the open fracture is there and if you fracture, there are soft tissue loss. We can use uniaxial fixator. Later on, we can use the Elizara fixator. And it's close fracture. And I think it is better to fix it with. If it is feasible and the surgeon is available and apparatus available, it is better to do primary Elizara fixation.
Thank you, sir. Thank you
very much, Dr. Arif.
Yes, Dr. Arif. There is a question from Julfikar Rajib. I am going to Kamruz Jaman for this question. Sir, if we put the wire near the zone 6 of the tibia, is there any restriction of weight bearing? From Julfikar Rajib, I have a question that Kamruz Jaman, got the question, sir?
Yes, I got the question.
If you put a wire in the zone 6 of tibia, is there any restriction of the weight bearing?
Restriction of weight bearing in zone 6, just above joint line, 2 cm above the joint line, you can put the wire and allow the movement, allow the weight bearing.
Okay.
I add something Dr. Hamidul Islam. In case of open tibia fibula, fracture, we actually in Bangladesh perspective we use the uniaxial external fixator primarily. But we have shown that is the literature we have published in the yesterday to reduce the cost. And to repeated intervention, repeated surgery, this is the burden for our patient. So we avoid the uniaxial external fixator if possible. Primarily, we do the Elizara to reduce the cost. To reduce the cost and repeated surgical intervention. If we don't, we only use the two ring above and two ring below. For the dressing purpose or something like that, we can use the telescopic rod, and later on you can also use the two ring support this. I heard from something from Professor Barisar about regarding this
zone 6
Hey, Arif.
Yes, sir. The question is that from Zulfikar Rajib, his question is that zone 6 wire placement, is there any restriction of the weight bearing? And no, if you want to put weight in fast post-operative way, is it possible, sir?
His why? No question. Why restriction of the weight bearing? You are using the wires, transosseous wires. Why? Zone 6, lower 1/3, above the ankle mortise. No restriction.
No restriction.
And no, why restriction? Why restriction for weight bearing?
Sir, he just,
I don't know.
Wanted to know.
No, sir. I don't understand why he has asked this question.
Okay, Zulfikar Rajib, I think you got your answer. And there is, I want to add one thing is that the ankle joint and foot, and dorsum of the foot is very close to this area. So for ring configuration, you must keep in mind that foot should be plantigrade. And is there no problems with the foot touching with the rings? This type of consideration you should keep in mind. Otherwise, there is no problem with weight bearing. You can put weight bear if the pain is permit and patient is okay, and it can put immediately after post-operative period, first POD. So I think you got your answer. And now
I want to give you another message.
Yes, sir, please.
When in 2000, 20 years back, I entered into the room of the Shepsov. Listen, just. Then he told me in Russian language, Nasha Zadacha Dvijenie Dvijenie Dvijenie. What does it mean? Our task is movement, and movement, nothing else. The whole center's task is movement, and movement. Still, I remember this. All the time when I see him, I tell him, Dvijenie, Dvijenie. You just Indians also, they learn like this one. Dvijenie, Dvijenie, Dvijenie. Movement.
Thank you, sir, for your nice comment. And usually, the post-operative care is a very much important thing for Elizarov success. And you know that our lecture also includes the rehabilitation. And our next lecture will be conducted by Hamidul Islam by Pintec Care. It is a very interesting one, and we should make a universal protocol so that we can follow the Pintec protocols. And now I am closing the question answer session because there is no further question in the chat box in the hot.
Dr. Kane, Arif, Dr. Kane is raising hand.
Okay, sir. I am just going to him. And just before going to Dr. Kane, I just want to announce is that we are going sequentially for the closing. That is from the both of the co-host, then Amir Hussain sir, then Mufakkarul Bari sir, and lastly I go to Ashok Shyam sir, for as this program is lively telecast on the Facebook in Ortho TV Facebook platform, so we need to stop the transmission also and everybody please be present on the 16th of this month. And Bari sir, you please have the announcement that about the tomorrow's as Elizarov birthday hotel, the Kurgan center program, and how can we connect it. You can have our instruction in your part. And now I'm going to Dr. Kane because Dr. Kane have a question. Dr. Kane, please have your question. And
yes, yeah, thank you very much for the beautiful lectures from the two presenters. I have a question for Professor Bari. My question is this. Is there any instance where you must fix the tibia and fibula, that is in zone 6, that you must fix it in when you applying Elizarov frame?
Repeat it again, please.
Thank you, sir. I got his question. Is there any instance when you must fix the fibula in doing the Elizarov?
Oh.
But some situation you can leave it, and some situation you must have to fix it. What are the situation when you must have to fix the fibula with the wires?
Yes, there are lots of situations. There are two syndesmoses in the tibiofibular joint, proximal syndesmosis and distal syndesmosis. If you fix the proximal, you don't need to do the distal. Sometimes you can fix the proximal and distal. You understand me?
Yes,
and
yes,
if you fix the distal, you don't need to go to the proximal. And it depends on your case. You should have to think yourself what kind of trauma and fracture geometry. Depending on that, you should have to fix that one. As for example, bimalleolar fracture. Bimalleolar fracture. Today I've shown in the Indian lecture. There, bimalleolar fracture. Your fibula is 5 cm or 6 cm broken. And medial malleolus, you want to fix it with also broken. You want to fix it with the Lizarro. You make a small incision and put a 1K wire through the fibula. Not place, nothing else. And from the wire, you can fit. And then from lateral side, you can fix the fibula also. You understand me? This is one situation. There are lots of situations that you should have to take and think yourself when and which place you should have to fix that one. Sometimes you can leave, but you should have to fix one, either proximally or distally.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. With your permission, you, I want to add one more thing. Is that for this issue? You have to think if you need a distraction maneuver in your frame, or you have to just put it for the fracture, rapid fracture tip. I request, please mute your microphone. Is the noise? That there are two issues. If you need distraction, or you just put Elizara for the acute fracture treatment. If you want to distract any bone fragment, if you need like distraction osteogenesis or any bone part distraction, you need must consider to fix the fibula in proximal and distal part. If you it is subjected to distraction, and if you do not put the distraction, it may cause the subluxation of the fibula head from the proximal part. Also, there is the distal part, also proximal migration happen. It is a very proof thing that distal proximal migration of the distal part also happened when it is subjected to the distraction. So, when you are put any distraction, you must consider about fixing the fibula. And if it is an acute fracture case, and there is one problem with fixing fibula. Fibular wire usually get infected very frequently. Fibular wire, it causes some skin irritation more. So this is one problem with the fibular proximal wire, usually proximal, not the distal wire. So in fracture case, you may leave the proximal fibula. You may leave, but definitely consider about the fracture geometry, and if it need for reduction, you must put the wire also. There is no restriction is there. I think you got your answer.
Sure.
And now
I am
seeing that Dr. Anon just raised his hand. Please make your question short. And Dr. Anon, we are running short of time. And Dr. Anon, can you hear me? Dr. Anon, you have raised your hand, and please unmute your microphone.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Can you hear now?
Yes, sir. I can hear
you.
Please
thank you.
Have your question
directly,
sir.
Okay. Sure. Thanks to both presenters for their nice presentation. Actually, learning is a journey. There is no destination. Professor Bari sir and others, assalamu alaikum and very good evening, sir.
Waalaikum salam.
I think most of the orthopedic surgeons, we do Elizaro surgery in open tibia fibula fracture. My question is to Dr. Hamidul Bhai, my elder brother, how you do dynamization in your case, Dr. Hamidul Bhai.
Okay, now we got your answer. Dr. Hamidul Islam, if we are online, please question about the technique of dynamization.
I have already mentioned, I think if you are in the... Yes, sir.
His question already answered.
Yes, answered.
Personally, you talk personally with him.
I have shown a picture there. How dynamization is done.
Dr. Anon, if you go through the lecture in the YouTube and also subscribe our channel, so you can get the answer because it will also repeat
no time,
your...
No time.
Yes, sir. And now there is a question from Adikunle. Sir, Adikunle sir is very much attentive always in our session. I ask him to unmute. Please have a question, sir.
I don't have a question. It's just a comment.
Yes, sir, please.
What you guys are doing. it's just a comment that I'm enjoying the thing and developing an interest in the Lizard Rock setting. So keep it up. I appreciate what you are doing. That's what I've been following. So thank you to everybody. So it's developing my interest.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Ken, my brother from Nigeria, I'm also greeting you.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Sir, I always appreciate this type of thing because the Nigerian friends are very much friendly, and every time they congratulate me and our team for this type of lecture. So I respect your feelings. And now I am going to Amir Hussain sir. Amir Hussain sir is in online. Okay, then if Amir Hussain sir is not present, then I am going to Ghulam Mostafa Shubro and please Nazmul Huda Shadu PPR for concluding speech. Ghulam Mostafa.
Yes. Finish. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Please make short comment.
Assalamu alaikum, everybody. Thanks to our today's two presenters. They nicely and elaborately presented their today's lecture. I think it will be helpful for the beginner and also refreshment for ourselves who are doing Elizarov. The discussion is also very nice, and it will also be helpful for us for clear our conception. Thank you, everybody, and invite you for the next session. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Nazmul Huda Shetu, before going to you,
yes.
I just want to.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Dr. Arif, and Dr. Kamru Jaman, and Dr. Hamid Jaman, and also the participants. This is the Bangladesh Kurgan Fellow Group started this session not only the knowledge build up, but also to inspire the new surgeons also to build up, to start their Elizarov surgery. That's why we will get more and more Elizarov surgeons. Then we will do the surgery at first time. That is the question, why not put Elizarov in primarily? It is actually lacking of our Elizarov surgeons. That's why we do not use the Elizarov primarily. When we have the lot of Elizarov surgeons, then the question will not arise. So it's our platform to inspire the beginners to build up them as a Elizarov surgeons. Then we will apply the Elizarov at first time. That is our goal. So thank you. Thank you, everyone. And welcome to the, invite you to next session. Thank you, everyone. Dr. Arif.
Yes, sir. Thank you for your nice words. And there is an announcement is that we will connect with Junjunwala sir in a later session. I will let you know all the details of the schedule. Junjunwala sir will want to speak in CPT in our session. So I think everyone, please get connected in the future sessions. And now I am going to Muhakkal Wari sir. Please have your concluding speech. We already 2 hours in our session. So I am going to Muhakkal Wari sir. Please have your concluding comments, sir.
Hi. Dear friends, I always, shout. Love Elizarov like your wife. Yes. Spouse. Love your wife, Elizarov. Then if you love your wife, there will be peace in your house. If peace in your house, everything is okay. Elizarov will show like this. I tell you, sincerely, no problem. Love Elizarov from the core of the heart. This is my message, nothing else. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Always, you are very much inspiring for all of us. And for your information, I want to, sir, keep a promise to you that you got your 7th fellow. And this 7th fellow is always with you and always try to...
Inshallah.
Elizarov technique in Bangladesh and also spread the Elizarov knowledge all over the world. And it is our commitment.
Now Rajesh is also with us always.
Yes, sir. Rajesh, sir, is always very much punctual for...
He's listening. He's gaining knowledge. Ken, Rajesh, Ajay Kunle, PRS, all.
Rajesh sir, greetings to you and Nepalian people from our platform.
Kinedum also.
Yes, sir. Now I am going to Samsudla sir, then Ashok Sham sir. Samsudla sir, if you can hear me, please connect and because you have to just stop the streaming also. Samsudla sir.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yes, sir. Should I make the host to Ashok Sham sir or to you, sir?
To Ashok Sham because he started live on Facebook.
Okay, sir. Okay.
I'll just let him know. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Then you please do your concluding comments about whole the session. I am Ashok Sham sir. Can you hear me, sir?
Thank you, Dr. Arif. It was a wonderful session. I was in hospital, so I couldn't listen to the full lecture. So I was not present full day today. So it was a very nice lecture. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And also for information that, sir, our channel and your channel also the Elizarov technique view interested people always encourage us for making our presentation better. And now I'm going to Ashok Sham, sir. Ashok Sham, sir, can you hear me, sir? Ashok Sham, sir, can you hear me?
Ashok Sham is coming. I just talked to him. Dr. Ashok Sham is coming.
Okay, sir. Then we need a couple of minutes to end the session. And before ending the session, if anyone want to add anything, because every day we got the PRS, sir. We want to go to PRS, sir, for have some comments. PRS, sir, already have messaged me that thanks, sir. Wonderful presentation. And if the PRS, sir, is online, please, you can connect with us.
No.
Yes, PRS, sir, is here.
Yeah? Okay.
Hello.
Hello, sir. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Yes, sir. We always waiting for hearing from you because you are very much punctual in our session. In every session, you don't miss any session. And please have some comments. Because we are at the end of the session, sir.
I both sir. Again, very little to explain. Only thing, I think the steps of particular was not that part. I think what is the method of doing particular and all.
Yes,
and,
sir.
The thing is that now that I think. Elizarov fixation primary fracture, like primary tibial fracture, is being extended, and I think it's good. So, one thing I wanted to ask was, but the other thing that in open fractures can we use primarily?
Thank you, sir. We got your question, sir. Sir, it is already discussed that if you have the expertise and you have the facilities, you can do the all the. Elizarov primarily, even we have the experience, even we can do the flap in Elizarov ring. If you have the expertise and the if the patient condition permit, you can do it. There is no contraindication. There are various papers are just in publications. So you can get how the primary Elizarov is going on all over the world. So thank you, sir, for being with us. And now, if the Ashok Sam sir is connected with us, yes, sir.
Arif, I just had a talk with Dr. Ashok. He said you can stop live streaming Facebook from your side also.
Okay, sir. Then I will make you the host. You can do that for us. Okay, sir. I'm making you the host, sir.
Okay. Okay. So with this thanking from Ortho TV side, I'm stopping the live stream. Thank you, Bari sir. Thank you, Arif. Thank you, Ashok Sham. Yeah, it's done.
Okay, sir. Then send back the host address to me.
Yeah, yeah.
And for your information, I will meet again on the 16th of this month. Probably the Junjunwala sir lecture will be 17th of this month. I am organizing and working on it. You will get all the feedback very soon.
One more thing, Dr. Arif.
Yes,
today,
sir.
There is some issue in your host that it was, I was unable to make it online on YouTube. I put it with Facebook. Just please check the your Zoom setting for YouTube.
Okay, sir. I will check it definitely.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir, for Thank you everyone for patience hearing and always be with us. Now I am at the end of the session. Just I'm stopping the meeting and assalamu alaikum. See you on tomorrow and stay safe. And also I am showing the Barisa salute and the sign of unity, and please stay safe and keep connecting, and we will be coming on the later session. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you all.
Wa alaikum salam. Okay.